Hello viewers, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Myself is Dr. Varsha Baweja from Department of Zoology, Deshbandhu College, University of Delhi. Today we are going to discuss module 25, endocrine disruptors of the paper Animal Physiology of the subject Zoology. Endocrine disrupting chemicals, or in short EDCs, are chemicals which may disrupt the functioning of endocrine system. A broad category of compounds used in consumer products, industrial dyes, paints and agricultural acts like EDC. These compounds have been associated with a diverse array of health issues like cancer, diabetes, hypertension and reproductive anomalies, etc. The levels of EDCs in urban and rural areas may vary depending on food habits and the anthropogenic activities of the local inhabitants. Exposure to EDCs can occur anywhere, that is from the air we breathe, the food we eat and the water we drink. EDCs can also enter the body through the skin and can enter the fetus from mother via placenta and can also enter the infant from mother via milk if a woman has EDCs in her body. You, me, everyone is exposed to hundreds of chemicals each day and these may interact in unforeseen ways. But all EDCs are not harmful in nature. Some of them may be used as medicines or nutraceuticals to improve our health. Therefore, it is very important to know which chemical falls under which category. Today's learning objectives are: what is an endocrine disruptor? What are the characteristics of endocrine disruptors? Types of endocrine disruptors? Timeline of endocrine disruptions? We will also understand the mechanism of endocrine disruption, factors affecting the impact of EDCs, effect of EDC on human and on the wildlife, and at the end we will discuss some preventive health care. According to Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, US, endocrine disrupting chemical or endocrine modulator, environmental hormone, is an exogenous agent that interferes with synthesis, secretion, transport, metabolism, binding action or elimination of natural blood-borne hormones that are present in the body and are responsible for hemostasis, reproduction and developmental process. In simple terms, endocrine disruptors are chemicals which may mimic hormones in our body, including the female sex hormone estrogen and male sex hormone androgen and thyroid hormone, etc. They may block hormonal signals in our body or interfere with the way the hormones or receptors are made or controlled. EDCs have small molecular mass, that is less than 1000 daltons, structurally quite similar to hormones like estrogen, but in action they may be different from hormones. The chemical structures of endocrine disrupting chemicals are variable and unpredictable. These chemicals can work even at very low levels. They have long half-lives, therefore also called persistent organic pollutants, that is POP. They don't get destroyed in short period of time and have higher persistence in nature. They biomagnify as well as they move through the food chain. Here you see these are the structures of natural hormones and this is of phytoestrogen and these are synthetic endocrine disrupting chemicals. All are showing similarity in their chemical structures. It's very difficult to determine whether a chemical is an endocrine disruptor or not by merely looking at its chemical structure. But despite so much similarity in structure, both endocrine disrupting chemicals and natural hormones are dissimilar to each other in various characteristics. Hormones act via binding to specifically to only one type of receptor, whereas EDC can bind with one or multiple types of receptors. After binding to receptor, normal hormone produces normal protein whereas EDC signals the production of faulty protein. For any action, hormone is required in very minute quantity, whereas EDC may act at both low and high doses. Hormones disintegrates after the action, whereas EDC may accumulate in the body, and with time, biomagnification of these chemicals takes place in the ecosystem. Depending on their nature, hormones are circulated either free or bound to transporter proteins. Hormones help in development, whereas EDC may interfere the development and causes prenatal and postnatal birth defects. EDCs can be classified into two types on the basis of their origin. Natural hormones are present in plants and plant products. They are estrogen like compounds, therefore known as phytoestrogens. Generally, plants are quite nutritious, but they may act as EDC. For example, flax seeds is an excellent source of omega-3 fatty acids and a great source of fiber. It is also known to be good in lowering cholesterol, protecting against heart disease, cancer and diabetes, and controlling high blood pressures. Likewise, soya bean, clover and jam, etc. also have many nutritional qualities, but they all possess phytoestrogens, which under certain circumstances or the overuse of these may cause disorders in human as well as in other vertebrates. So, what is phytoestrogen? Phytoestrogen is plant-derived estrogen, also called as xenoestrogen or dietary estrogen. They are non-steroidal plant compounds. Structurally, phytoestrogen is quite similar to 17-beta-estradiol, hence act as endocrine disrupting chemicals. Another type of EDC is synthetic endocrine disruptors. These are man-made chemicals and non-steroidal in nature. Such chemicals have ubiquitous exposure due to their dispersal via air, water, soil, and even by migratory animals. Examples are household products, that is breakdown products of detergents and associated surfactants including nonylphenol and octylphenol. Personal care products like deodorants, perfumes, nail paints, etc. Pesticides, DDT, endosulfan, atrazine, nitrofen and tributyltin. Plastics like bisphenol A, phthalates, etc. Pharmaceuticals, drugs, estrogen, birth control pills, DES, cimetidine, industrial chemicals like polychlorinated biphenyls, that is PCBs, dioxins and benzopyrene. Byproducts of incineration, paper production and fuel combustion. Metals like cadmium, lead, mercury. The food rich in fatty acids or fish grown in contaminated water can be a rich source of these contaminants. History teaches us a lot. So, in this section, we will learn about some chemicals which act as EDC. Though these are synthesized for some other purpose, like DDT, a pesticide was first introduced in 1947. Use of DDT was common in the late 1940s to 1960s. Bald eagles consumed prey which had high levels of this pesticide concentrated in their fatty tissues. It has been observed that these eagles' ingestion of DDT, a metabolite of DDT, prevented adequate calcium deposition during eggshell formation. This resulted in eggs with thin shells and cracked fairly easily during incubation. Consequently, there was a significant decline in the population of bald eagles in United States. In 1962, publication of Silent Spring of Rachel Carson publicly exposed DDT as endocrine disruptor. She also discussed the process by which DDT entered the food chain, including human beings, and caused cancer and genetic damage. Her book's most haunting and famous chapter, A Fable for Tomorrow, depicted a nameless American town where all life from fish to birds to apple blossoms to human children had been silenced by the insidious effects of DDT. In 1980, DDT was again reported as EDC due to about 80 to 95% of alligator eggs at Lake Apopka failed to hatch due to its exposure. In 1938, DES, that is diethylstilbestrol, a synthetic estrogen, was invented by Charles Dodson and Robinson. 1938 to 1971, DES was prescribed to pregnant women to prevent miscarriages and other related problems like postpartum lactation separation, gonorrheal vaginitis and atrophic vaginitis in US. In 1966, Huggins won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for the use of DES to treat prostate cancers. It was discovered in 1970 that taking DES during the first 5 months of pregnancy can alter the proper development of fetal reproductive systems. Daughters born to women who took DES may have structural abnormalities in their vagina, cervix and uterus. They may also have irregular menstruation and difficulties in pregnancy such as infertility, miscarriage, ectopic pregnancy and giving birth prematurely. Some of these women have also suffered from a rare cancer known as clear cell adenocarcinoma. There have also been problems for sons of mothers who took DES. These men may have testicular abnormalities. In 1971, US, the FDA banned the use of DES during pregnancy. In 1960, Ming suffered reproductive failure due to the consumption of PCB contaminated fish from Lake Michigan. In Japan, 1968, and Taiwan in 1979, the rice bran oil that may people consumed in these two countries was contaminated with PCBs and their pyrolysis products PCDFS. Developmental delays was reported in fetuses of the mother who has consumed rice bran oil contaminated with PCBs. In 1976, polychlorinated biphenyls were detected in fish of Hudson River, due to which fishing became banned on Hudson River. BPA was first synthesized in 1891 by Russian chemist Alexander P. Dynin. BPA polycarbonate plastics are exceptionally strong and stable. They can endure exposure to high temperatures, enabling them to withstand heating in microwave ovens. In late 20th century, BPA found its widest use in plastics, including baby bottles, toys, as well as in medical devices such as heart-lung machines, incubators, artificial kidneys, hemodialysis, and dental sealants and fillers. Its estrogenic behavior was discovered in the early 1990s when a team led by American endocrinologist David Feldman unexpectedly discovered BPA in growth medium in polycarbonate flask used to culture yeast cells. From the mid-1990s, numerous studies determined that both high-level and low-level exposure to BPA can adversely affect reproduction and development in human and other animals by interfering with endocrine systems. In 1991, a wing-spread conference at Wisconsin brought together experts from ecology to biology to toxicology, who reached the consensus that environmental chemicals could interfere with the endocrine system in human and animal with long-term consequences. The meeting codified the concept of endocrine disruption. In 1996, an eye-opener publication, Our Stolen Future, Are We Threatening Our Fertility, Intelligence and Survival? By Theo Kalborn et al., effectively raised public awareness of issues related to endocrine disruption. In 1999, another eye-opener, Generations at Risk, Reproductive Health and Environment by Hudl et al., enlightened the world about the human exposure to some toxic chemicals that can have lifelong and even intergenerational effects on human reproduction and development. In 2000, in a book, Hormonal Chaos, by Sheldon Krimsky, discussed about the chemicals which cause genetic mutations in somatic cells, along with the concept that mutations are associated with development of cancer cells. There is a long list of chemicals and phytoestrogens which are now considered to be endocrine disrupting chemicals. Please refer the text to know the sources, mechanism of action, damage, etc. Before discussing the mechanism disruption, we should quickly have a glance first on the endocrine system. You know that the endocrine system is a controlling system of our body. It consists of various glands like the pituitary, thyroid, adrenal, thymus, pancreas, ovaries, and testes, which release carefully measured amount of hormones into the bloodstream that act as natural chemical messengers, traveling to different parts of the body via blood in order to control and adjust many life functions. Any effect on these systems can lead to obesity, infertility, or reduced fertility, learning and memory difficulties, adult onset diabetes, or cardiovascular diseases, as well as a variety of other diseases. You might suspect altering this precise system is just like playing with fire, yet it can happen on a daily basis when we use normal everyday products in our daily routine. EDCs may interfere with hormones by disrupting the following aspects of hormone metabolism, that is synthesis, secretion, storage, transport, binding, action, elimination, affect gene transcription, affect proteasome-linked degradation of receptors. Endocrine disrupting chemicals can act at multiple sites through multiple mechanisms of action. These chemicals exert their effect primarily through nuclear hormone receptors, including estrogen receptors, androgen receptors, progesterone receptors, thyroid receptors, and retinoid receptors, as well as non-nuclear steroid hormone receptors, for example, membrane receptors, non-steroid receptors like serotonin receptor, dopamine receptors, norepinephrine receptors, orphan receptors like aryl hydrocarbon receptors, and orphan receptor, enzymatic pathways involved in steroid biosynthesis and or metabolism, and numerous other mechanisms that can converge upon endocrine and reproductive system. So broadly, this mechanism is either receptor based or non-receptor based. First, we will discuss receptor based disruption. This type of disruption may be caused due to two types of receptors, that is membrane receptors or nuclear receptors. Membrane receptors are those receptors which are embedded in target cell membrane. These are integral proteins or glycoproteins. They act in cell signaling by binding to extracellular molecules. For example, G protein coupled receptor, enzyme linked receptors, etc. Nuclear receptors are those receptors that act in pair and bind to specific hormone recognition elements, that is HRE, which are known sequences on the DNA in the promoter region of target genes. Endocrine disrupting chemicals can bind to the receptors due to being very close to normal hormone structurally. However, they may trigger activities differently in terms of action and intensity comparing to normal hormone. This difference in activity may be due to altered shape of hormone receptor complex, which may not further trigger the normal enzyme production, which ultimately result in the production of faulty protein. This is the reason that even at minimal doses, these EDCs may block the action of receptor. PXR and CAR, the members of NR superfamily of sensor receptors. The nuclear receptors, pregnin X receptor and constitutive androstenedione receptor, that is CAR or NR113, were originally identified as xenosensors that regulate the expression of phase 1 and phase 2 drug metabolizing enzymes and transporters. They also have important endobiotic roles in energy metabolism by affecting the metabolism of fatty acids, lipids and glucose. PXR and CAR exert their effects on energy metabolism through direct gene regulation or through crosstalk with other transcriptional regulators. Hence, EDC can disrupt the nuclear receptor function by activation or modulation of gene expression, inhibition of gene expression, synergism or inhibition by competition at regulatory sites, competition with co-activator of nuclear receptors and degradation of nuclear receptor by proteasome activation. Many endocrine disrupting chemicals do not interact with the receptor of the cell, but disturb the signaling pathways. There are several ways by which signaling pathways may get disturbed without binding to any receptor and cause disruption. They may stop the production of enzymes which are necessary for the production of normal steroid hormones from cholesterol. They may enhance the production of enzymes which are responsible for removing the unwanted chemicals and excess of normal hormone from the body. They may interrupt the movement of hormones by changing the action of transporter proteins. They may disturb the production of receptors. They may disturb the release of hormones from their respective glands. They may disturb the signaling pathways by interrupting the availability or action of secondary messengers such as cyclic AMP. There are many factors which may affect the impact of EDC. First is dose of EDC. Chemicals which disrupt the action of normal hormones need not to be present in large amount to have a lasting impact. They can bring about their effect at very low doses. You know, the impact of such chemicals also depend on the exposure of organism to more than one EDCs, because chemicals may have additive or synergistic effect. Second one is age of target organism. The time of action of EDCs is also important. If the action is made in the fetal period, then it affects the fetal development. But sometimes the effect may not manifest in fetal development, but it may show its action later in life. If their action occurs in adulthood, it may interfere with normal hormone functions and causes disease like diabetes, hypertension, etc. The third factor is nature of target cell. The exposure sometimes affects the germline or modify the factors that regulate gene expression, such as histone acetylation and DNA methylation. Hence, the impact of EDC may be epigenetic. Last one is latency of exposure. It is seen in many cases that symptoms may not appear immediately after the exposure, but may appear in adulthood or in future generations. A lag may exist between the time of exposure and manifestation of the disorder. The long-term latent effects of EDC can have an effect on many people because EDC target factors which regulate gene expression, the modification may be passed on. Thus, the exposure of one person to a particular EDC may have medical implications on future generations. To understand the impact of EDC on human and wildlife, let's learn more from some case studies. Do you know? Case studies from various parts of the world have shown the presence of EDCs in 98% of samples of human urine and plasma, indicating long environmental exposure of these chemicals. EDCs have been shown to be high in the human body with various ailments like cancer, PCOS, diabetes, obesity, early puberty, heart diseases, and brain disorders. These chemicals also have notable effects on the reproductive system of male as well as female. It is believed that early exposure to EDC can cause hypospadias, congenital cryptorchidism, poor semen quality, testicular dysgenesis syndrome, and testicular germ cell cancer. In females, exposure to EDC can be the cause of reproductive disorders in females like polycystic ovarian syndrome, uterine fibroids, and endometriosis. It was found that fungicides vinclozolin and dichlorodiphenyl dichloroethylene that act as androgen receptor antagonists and phthalate esters, dibutyl phthalate, and dibutyl hexyl phthalate that disturb androgen biosynthesis. Prenatal exposure to lead glycol ethers and other such chemicals has been shown to increase the risk of miscarriages, preeclampsia, preterm delivery, and poor fetal weight. High levels of DDT were associated with a 5-fold increase in the risk of breast cancer. Several EDCs like PCB and brominated flame retardants, phthalates, bisphenol A, and perfluorinated chemicals have adverse effects on thyroid functions too. Attention deficit hyperactive disorder is seen to be associated with elevated exposure to organophosphates. Many insecticides like dioxins, PCBs, and heavy metals are known to be associated with breast cancer and prostate cancer. It was found in one study that in women born after 1931, high level of DDT were associated with a 5-fold increase in the risk of breast cancer. Diabetes 2 risk is increased after exposure to persistent organic pollutants like PCBs, DDT, dioxin, organochlorine pesticides, hexachlorobenzene, arsenic, and some flame retardants. Effect. Now we'll learn effect of EDC exposure on wildlife. You might be aware of that wildlife population in the world is dwindling. This can be attributed to several reasons. One of the reasons is the environmental impact of EDCs, polluting soil, food, water, and air. These effects being now well understood, and it has led to ban of their use. As previously we discussed that their lifespan is long, they continue to cause ill effects on wildlife health. Now, if we talk about invertebrates, then imposex has been reported in many populations of marine snails around the world. The effect was linked to exposure of tributyltin, that is TBT, anti-fouling paints used on boats. TBT has also been found to affect mud snails and shell development in oysters and various reproductive anomalies in amphipods, copepods, and freshwater snail and marine snail. EDC in the waste outflow from pulp and paper mills and sewage treatment plants can affect reproduction and development in fish. A variety of endocrine changes are involved, like in UK, anglers were found to be hermaphroditic because the male anglers started producing vitellogenin, a yolk protein which in normal circumstances produced in female fish under the influence of estrogen. Researchers tried to find out the reason, but no estrogen was found in effluents or sewage water. Rather, they could be able to discover that this change is due to the presence of a non-hormonal chemical, that is nonylphenol ethoxylate, which is used in industries as a surfactant. Similar reproductive anomalies have also been reported in Xenopus livers after the exposure of EDCs. Vitellogenin production was observed in male frog due to the exposure of DDE and gonadal abnormalities due to herbicide etrazine. It was found that etrazine increases the activity of enzyme aromatase, which further enhances the conversion of testosterone to 17-beta-estradiol. Vitellogenin induction, changes in sexual differentiation, changes in hormone levels and developmental difficulties have all been found to occur in alligator population when exposed to potentially endocrine disrupting chemicals. Similar results were also observed in male western fence lizards even at very low dose, that is 0.003 milligram per kilogram of 17-beta ethinyl estradiol. In birds, eggshell thinning and altered sex organ development and severe population decline have been observed in a range of birds that include white-tailed sea eagle, osprey, hawk, Forster's tern, western gull, herring gull, cormorants, duck, common tern and crown knight heron after the exposure to the large number of potential EDCs like PCBs, DDT, DDE, methylmercury, methoxychlor, polychlorinated dibenzodioxins and polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. In mammals, reproductive impairment, immune suppression and mescalinization have been found to be associated with exposure to PCBs, DDT-like compounds, PCDDDs, mercury and dieldrin in various marine mammals and other like bears, mink, otters and panthers. Now at the end, we should discuss some do's and don'ts for leading a healthy life. First of all, avoid use of plastics. Babies should not be fed in plastic bottles. Water should be filtered before use. Personal care products should be EDC free. Before buying, check the content that it should be free from phthalates, etc. Avoid water resistance cloth, furnitures and carpets. Natural cleansing agents should be used in place of synthetic one. Artificial air fresheners should not be used. Toys used should be BPA free. Let's summarize the points which we learned today. Endocrine disruptors, that is EDCs, are chemicals which mimic or antagonize hormone action. They are similar to steroid hormone in structure. They can act at very low or high doses. They can be of natural or synthetic source. They have long half-life and they bioaccumulate in food and animal. They can be ingested in by air, food, water, skin and can also be passed on to fetus by a pregnant mother. They act as pollutants and are adversely affecting the health of men and wildlife. Use of all those products which are sources of EDCs are being banned by government and alternative products are coming to the market. But since they have a very long life, they continue to act as carcinogens, obscenogens or for long period of time. It is very important for us to learn ways to minimize their exposure on our body. I conclude with Rachel Carson quote, one way to open your eyes is to ask yourself, what if I had never seen this before? What if I know I would never see it again? Thank you.